In my last video, I mentioned three options for a flat earther to respond to a question. In reaction to that video, I was confronted with a fourth possibility. They do react, but when they get shown that their reaction is just baseless nonsense, they just delete the thread that they themselves started altogether. This video is not about this incident itself. It is about the content that was brought as evidence of the opinion that the 60 nautical miles per degree cannot work on a globe and only on a flat earth. The thread started like this. The whole ball stationary and non-rotating thing I'll let slide here. But he goes on. Because the ball earth distortion, you would have to use a different distance per degree for each celestial light geocentric position for every observation. Example. On the ball a terrestrial earth, 69 miles per degree is only along the equator and north-south meridians. Everything else is less miles per degree. Globe terrestrial earth miles per degree of longitude at the equator is 69 miles. At 30 degrees north-south, 60 miles. At 45 north-south, 49 miles. At 60 degrees north-south, only 35 miles per degree longitude. No accurate depiction. If you use a sextant on the Earth, you are doing it on a flat plane, not a distorted Earth terrestrial globe where the land does not fit without shrinking it going north or south of the equator. This word salad is a lot of woo-hoo. First, I was astounded by those numbers. Where did he get them from? What has been his thought process? And then it dawned to me. He had made a mistake only a three-dimensional illiterate could have made. I found out that the 60 miles at 30 degrees north and south, 49 miles at 45 degrees north and south, and 35 miles at 60 degrees north and south per degree longitude was derived from planes parallel to the equator at those respective latitudes. My first surprise was that Iron FE, or Iron Flat Earth, managed to calculate these numbers correctly in the first place. What was less surprising was that he had it so terribly wrong. He seems to still think that the shortest distance between two points at the same latitude is the part of the circle parallel to the equator through those both points. And it isn't. The shortest distance between two points on a ball is a great circle through those two points. But what's worse in this case is that he tries to prove, and I use that word lightly, that the 60 nautical miles per degree doesn't work on a globe by trying to apply that formula to the longitude angle, an angle that isn't measured in the first place, and on top of that, it has nothing to do whatsoever with either the star, the GP of the star, the place where the observer does his observation from, nor the direction he is looking in. The whole purpose of celestial navigation on a globe is that the plane formed by the observer, the star and the GP of the star is the same as the plane through the center of the Earth in which plane the 60 nautical miles per degree is applied. This is basic geometry, something Iron FE obviously hasn't understood. After being called upon his horrible error, he first reacted with, "Something cannot be done on the theoretical ball Earth, that is why you have to use ridiculous nonsense." Later on, he decided to delete the entire thread. I could have left it at that, but I'm afraid he's going to spread his nonsense elsewhere, like at Nathan Oakley's shit show. In no time, this whole silly narrative will spread over the entire Flat Earth community. At least then I can say, I have warned them.